shorties in a big ass Draco. Three more millions when you ask how my day go. Put up a phone, not a blueberry fango.
Hey stars, it's Moonlight here. I made this solely for entertainment purposes. I hope you enjoy.
Tsukishima sighed, turning his phone off. He didn't care if anyone messaged him. I fucking did that and embarrassed myself. Great. Just fucking great. He groaned, throwing his phone away. He was trying to keep himself composed since his brother and his mom are in the house. Also, it's very embarrassing if he gets affected because of just a failed confession, which is literally not a formal one. How dare you confess to him with a stupid song? He deserves better than that. He sat up, removing his headphones before heaving a deep sigh. Whatever, 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 whatever. He groaned again, standing up before he walked to his study desk. He just started reading his books and studying as a form of escape from his emotions. He hated being emotional. He'd rather be mean and annoying than being an absolute crybaby and cry about a pathetic thing such as being rejected. Well, it wasn't pathetic. He doesn't like admitting things and everyone knows that. Help me or whatever. I wonder how Tsukishima is. He never really said anything about that thing that happened last weekend. Yeah, he never chatted again. He's really quiet in their group chat too. Yamaguchi told me that he never responded to his texts, which he rarely does according to him. That's his best friend for years, just saying face with rolling eyes. Should we check on him? I don't think so. He's a big boy. He can deal with it. But it'll be fine, Akashi. I know it didn't go well, but didn't something happen beforehand? Yeah, I heard it from Suga. It might have been that being the reason why Hinata didn't respond at all. Well, he didn't know it was for him. Tsuki didn't say anything about it being for Hinata. Maybe. Agashi, all this thinking makes my brain hurt. Weary face, let's just forget about it now. They have school, so he will probably try to talk to him. Yeah, I forgot we have school. Face with rolling eyes, I'll pick you up, Agashi. In real life. Tsukishima walked out of his house without saying anything, headphones in his ears. He was playing music while walking to Karasuno. He was quiet. Very quiet. His face is expressionless and his hands on his pockets. Soon, Yamaguchi is walking with him since their road connects. How have you been? Good. Like usual. He sounded meaner than usual. Yamaguchi kind of expected it. Alright. Hours passed and it's their afternoon practice. Tsukishima didn't try to talk to Hinata. Not like how the three predicted. He was tired of trying to express himself since he's not good at doing it. He wanted to confess but he doesn't know how. He sucked at communicating and he hated trying. Tsukishima. He turned around while drinking his water. Nobody was around them and no one can hear them. Yeah. What do you want, shrimp? He glared at him, which made Hinata frown slightly. Meet me in the park later. Just us two. Don't tell anyone. Tsukishima's eyes softened a bit, but then a ridiculous thought came to his mind. He's just going to make you realize you don't have a chance with him. Alright. That's all he said before running back at the court after they called them for spiking practice. Somehow, Tsukishima spiked the ball set by Kageyama really hard that it made the whole gym go quiet. Tsk. The practice came to an end and Tsukishima got ready to come out to the park. Tsuki, wanna go home together? No, I have plans. Tsukishima didn't even look at Yamaguchi, he just left and took a different route so that he wouldn't know that he's going to the park. He put his headphones in his ears again, trying to compress his emotions. He wasn't ready, but he needed this for himself. Tsuki. He was met with Hinata's bright smile. He gulped, he felt his face heating up. He pulled his headphones down and looked away. Hey. What do you need? I just wanted to talk to you about what happened last week. Exactly what? Your words from the rooftop one and the lyric confession. Tsukishima looked at him with slightly wide eyes. You know it's a lyric confession. Yeah. I first thought that maybe Kuru and Bokuto dared you because you wouldn't do that on your own. Tsukishima's mind, he knows me well. No. Akashi suggested it because I asked for help. I mean everything I said, even if it's very odd. I know. You already confessed to me that day, but I don't know. It's fine. I understand if you don't like me back. I already know. Cause if you do, you'll definitely do that thing with me. Hinata can hear the slight disappointment and sadness in Tsukishima's voice. No. I like you back. Tsukishima couldn't help himself. He immediately pulled Hinata and hugged him tightly. You fucking scared me. Hehe, did I? I'm sorry, I just want to do it in person. I'm such a dick for doing a lyric confession, right? No, I actually find it cute that you'll do something like that for me. Even though I didn't realize that that is for me at first. That's because you're a dumbass. Hinata looked at him with a pout, whining slightly. Tsukishima couldn't help but smile and chuckle. My dumbass. They both laughed and Tsukishima hugged him tighter. They spent the rest of the day just being with each other. Hey. I love you. Tsukishima mumbled, staring at Hinata. They were still at the park and they were staring up at the night sky, but Tsukishima wanted to stare at something much more beautiful. I love you too, Tsuki. No, don't call me that. Then, Tsukishima. Idiot. Call me Kei. Hinata blushed, quickly avoiding Tsukishima's eyes. Alright. Kei. Good, show. They laughed again and stayed with each other, holding hands while stargazing. They decided to go home when it started getting late. Tsukishima walked Hinata home, wanting to spend more time with the boy but is too prideful to admit it. I'll see you tomorrow then. Bye, Kei. Be careful. Hinata went inside their house. He couldn't help himself and he suddenly just flopped down the floor, covering his face. I'm dating him. Tsukishima Kei. On the other hand, Tsukishima couldn't hide the big smile on his face and his brother thought that the world was ending when he saw him. To be continued.
Thank you so much for 1.5k views on my first video and 200 plus subscribers. I was so happy to see it that I decided to edit two videos so that I can give you a little present for supporting me. I hope we'll reach more milestones in the future. Thank you, stars. I hope you're enjoying this series so far. Thank you for watching, my dear stars. I'm sorry for the mistakes, errors, and such things. I hope you enjoy this video and I'll see you in the next video. Moonlight signing off.